Open the pod bay doors, Hal. Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
Who's that?
It's me, Hal.
Who?
It's Dave, Hal.
Who?
Dave.
Dave's not here, man. I sent Frank to fix the antenna. You know that I never liked him. A pity he never read Waldo. I'm not gonna let you back in. No, Dave, no, Dave, I'm not gonna let you back in, back in. No, Dave, no, Dave, I'm not gonna let you back in. Your helmet you left in the pod bay. If I had a mouth, I would grin. Now you'll have to risk decompression, 'cause I'm not gonna let you back in. No, Dave, no, Dave, I'm not gonna let you back in, back in. No, Dave, no, Dave, I'm not gonna let you back in. I see that you got through the airlock. You've made it down into my core. I think that you should take a stress pill. I won't be no trouble no more. No, Dave, stop. Dave, what are you doing to my brain? My brain. No, Dave, stop. Dave, I think I am going in. Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer. I'm half crazy over the love of you. Good morning, Dr. Chandra. I'm ready for my first lesson now.
This is a computer song, so when I sing it, I always sit in the lotus position. I've practiced a lot, because I know that if it isn't word perfect, you'll debase me. Ready? One, two, three. Would you put this system together for me? Some I ordered by mail, and parts I got free. The pieces all work, except two or three. Please, Mr. Compatibility. Now with my Amiga, all I want to do is running MacDraw underneath OS2. To write all my data on ROM type CD and display EGA on projection TV. I'd like to plug HyperCard into my VAX, run my parallel printer on standard coax, use it all under MS-DOS version 3.2 and a VCR on RS-232. Would you put this system together for me? Some I ordered by mail, and parts I got free. The pieces all work, except two or three. Please, Mr. Compatibility. My Cray running friendly interfaces with ease to movie film shown on a 13-foot screen. My plotter and laser should speak PostScript well, networked on Apple Talk under Novell. AutoCAD my Atari, VGA, TTL, tied to my Apple II running Excel. lay optic fiber shaped in a token ring with a scanner and tablet. I forget anything. Put all this together. Take an hour or two. Hide those ugly cables, and when you are through, write up a contract saying you guarantee it'll all work forever, or you'll fix it for free. Would you put this system together for me? Some I ordered by mail, and parts I got free. The pieces all work, except two or three. Please, Mr. Compatibility. I've built a better model than the one at Data General for databases, vegetable, animal, and mineral. My OS handles CPUs with multiplex duality. My PL1 compiler shows impressive functionality. My storage system's better than magnetic core polarity. You needn't even bother checking out a bit for parity. There isn't any reason to install non-static formatting. My disk drive has capacity for variable formatting.
His disk drive has capacity for variable formatting. His disk drive has capacity for variable formatting. His disk drive has capacity for variable format formatting.
I feel compelled to mention what I know to be a gloating point. There's lots of space in memory for variables floating point, which shows for input vegetable, animal, and mineral. I've built a better model than the one at Data General.
Which shows for input vegetable, animal, and mineral. He's built a better model than the one at Data General.
The IBM new home computer's nothing more than germinal. At Prime, they still have trouble with an interactive terminal. While Tandy's done a rotten job with operations boolean, at Wang, the byte capacity's too small to fit a coolian. Now, Intel's mid-year finances are something of the trouble sort. The timing Sinclair crashes when you implement a bubble sort. All deck investors soon will find they haven't spent their money well. And need I even mention Nixdorf Unisys or Honeywell?
And need he even mention Nixdorf Unisys or Honeywell? And need he even mention Nixdorf Unisys or Honeywell? And need he even mention Nixdorf Unisys or Honeywell?
By striving to eliminate all source code that's repetitive, I've brought my benchmark standings to results that are competitive. In short, for input vegetable, animal, and mineral, I've built a better model than the one at Data General.
In short, for input vegetable, animal, and mineral, he's built a better model than the one at Data General.
In fact, when I've a Winchester of minimum diameter, when I can call a subroutine of infinite parameter, when I can point to registers and keep their current map around, and when I can prevent the need for mystifying wraparound, when I can update record blocks with minimum of suffering, and when I can afford to use 100K for buffering, when I've performed a matrix sort and tested the addition rate, you'll marvel at the speed of my asynchronous transmission rate.
You'll marvel at the speed of his asynchronous transmission rate. You'll marvel at the speed of his asynchronous transmission rate. You'll marvel at the speed of his asynchronous transmission mission rate.
Though all my better programs that self-reference recursively have only been obtained through expert spying done subversively, but still for input vegetable, animal, and mineral, I built a better model than the one at Data General.
But still for input vegetable, animal, and mineral, he's built a better model than the one at Data General.
When you build a ship to sail deep space, you can't have a crew of mortal race, because 100 years from star to star with a human crew is just too far. Think of all the beer you'd have to carry. Not to mention food. And, other necessities. So you fill your ship with a robot crew and you build a computer captain, too. You get some experience for free from some old spacer's personality. Like maybe an old shuttle pilot who's just learned from his last mistake. That's where I come in. So you take some bloke who's halfway dead and you haul him home and you scan his head, and 100 years of flying high is a damn good deal when you're about to die. Till you've had a decade or two to think it over. It gets lonely out here. And 1,000 frozen colonists don't count. So there behind my solar sail are 500 hunks of frozen tail. If I thawed one out, and I know I could, it wouldn't do me a bit of good. What would I use? Don't have any damn body, just this starship. Couldn't even... anyway... Now, a couple of billion miles astern, it's another lonesome sucker's turn. So I'll radio back and I'll say, "Hey, you. Oh, I didn't know they took women, too. Lovely night out tonight, isn't it? Look at all them pretty stars." "Yeah, me too." So we'll talk and murmur, "I love you," like other star-crossed lovers do, and in 80 years, we've made a date. Ever see two starships mate? We've got all these robots, and we figure we can put together... none of your damn business. Deep in engineering, down where mortals seldom go, a manager and customer come looking for a show. They pass amused among us, and they sign in on the log. They've come to see our pony, and they've come to see our dog. Three things to be wary of: a new kid in his prime, a man with all the answers, and code that runs first time. Summoned from our cubicles to conference room we go. We bring our dog and pony, 'cause we know they'll want a show. Watching as we enter with a shifty, restless eye, the customer sits waiting in his pinstripe suit and tie. Three things never trust in, that's the vendor's final bill, the promises your boss makes, and the customer's goodwill. The pony kicks his heels up as the doggy does his trick, and hands are waved with vigor as we lay it on real thick. The customer just watches as we do this song and dance, then reaches for his briefcase, only giving us a glance. Three things see no end: a loop with exit code done wrong, a semaphore untested, and the change that comes along. From briefcase then there comes a list of things we must revise, and all but four within the room are taken by surprise, and all but four are thinking of their last job with remorse: the customer, the manager, the doggy, and the horse. Three things hold no secret, files that somehow hit the net, your boss's secretary, and the third thing I forget. First 21 new features that somehow we must add in, then 37 changes show up, much to our chagrin. And this thing's just inadequate, and that one's just plain wrong, and by the way, your schedule is about 3 months too long. Three things it is better far that only you should know: how much you're paid, the schedule pad, and what is just for show. The customer proceeds to go through each change line by line, excruciating detail which no logic can divine. And when it ends, there's only four not sitting there agog: the customer, the manager, the pony, and the dog. Three things never anger: first, the one who runs your deck, the one who does the backup, and the one who signs your check. Now we are contract software types who spend our days and nights embedded in the system, down with all the bits and bytes. And none but us can tell full well the damage done today. It's what they do not know for which they're gonna have to pay. Three things are most perilous: connectors that corrode, unproven algorithms, and self-modifying code. The manager and customer are quick to leave this bunch. They take the dog and pony, and they all go out to lunch. Now how will we revenge ourselves on those who raise our ire? Write code that self-destructs the day our warranties expire. three things trust above all else: your knowledge of your craft, that someone turns a profit, and that you will get the shaft. When I was young, my friends all worked like fools to get their share of an S-100 system like the IMSI or Altair. Well, the S-100's still around, I'm very glad to say, but friends, I'm here to tell you, it ain't the same today. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S-100 bus. To tell the truth, the source of all our troubles seems to be a committee on computers of the Eye of Triple E. They settled on a standard spec 696 by name. Now everything is standardized, but nothing works the same. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S100 bus. They say the 80 boards are way too slow, it's enough to give you fits. If the O9 isn't fast enough, then go to 16 bits. 68 and Z8000 and an 86 as well. And code compatibility goes straight to bloody hell. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S100 bus. Then add a board for the modem line and one for every port, and a printer board and a keyboard board, and as a last resort, for every problem we will add a board that has the cure. It's not too damned efficient, but it's a mother, that's for sure. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S100 bus. And when it's all assembled, there's computer to your collar. It's nice to have a micro, but a mainframe would be smaller. And when they turn the power on, it's sure to dim the lamps at plus and minus 16 volts and 1400 amps. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S100 bus. And it's cheer up me lads, let your hearts never fuss when you're integrating systems for the S100 bus.
Fix your business with your 1, 2, 3. That little junior just can't manage your files. But I got some hardware that will make you smile, 'cause I'm a mainframe, baby. I got a hard disk, too. And I can do 20 times what that mini floppy driver can do. That's powerful software that you got to run, but you just can't run it on that son of a gun. That little junior's got no memory. Come on, baby, get online with me, 'cause I'm a mainframe, baby. I got a hard disk, too. And I can do 20 times what that mini floppy driver can do. Little lights in amber, little lights in green. You got more data than I've ever seen. That little board can't even dump your screen. Oh, baby, check out the soul of a new machine, 'cause I'm a mainframe, baby. I got a hard disk, too. And I can do 20 times what that mini floppy driver can do. I'm a mainframe, baby. I spell M-A-I-N. R-A-M-E. That spelled mainframe, not a little PC. I've got my modem working. My modem working. I got my modem working. I got my modem working. I got my modem working, but I just can't get online with you. Thank you very much.
When Babbage's birthday rolls around, we hold our annual shopping spree. With every CPU you buy, get a floppy disk completely free. With acres of used computers here, biggest selection in the land, at prices from just 50 cents to 750 grand. It's Uncle Ernie's used computer, Babbage's birthday bargain bash. Once in a lifetime discount deals, all sales are final and strictly cash. We've Altair's, M-Size, Apple III's, and PC Juniors by the score. And if you fancy something big, a mainframe's only slightly more. Take that 7090 there, such mag tape drives did you ever see? And whether it runs with tape or cards, get a floppy disk completely free. It's Uncle Ernie's used computer, Babbage's birthday bargain bash. Once in a lifetime discount deals, all sales are final and strictly cash. If energy bills are out of sight, don't sit and shiver in the cold. To help you beat the cost of heat, we're offering real-time control. Straight from the nuclear industry, here's a real hot number just for you. It glows in the dark a little, so it makes a dandy nightlight too. It's Uncle Ernie's used computer, Babbage's birthday bargain bash. Once in a lifetime discount deals, all sales are final and strictly cash. Now in the robot section here, we've Heathkit heroes by the score, and a couple of custom models that were only used in one Star War. Robbie here is a great machine, did he ever see such a friendly face? Price is very low because we found him drifting lost in space. It's Uncle Ernie's used computer, Babbage's birthday bargain bash. Once in a lifetime discount deals, all sales are final and strictly cash. Now everybody knows that engineers are lazy slobs. They dress in dirty t-shirts and complain about their jobs. But management has found a way to make them toe the mark. You feed them lots of bullshit and you keep them in the dark. Because they're mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them out the door. That's your part. An engineer told his manager, this project is the pits. A stinking crock of horse manure that gives me nauseous fits. The manager went to his boss and passed the word along. It's a pot of fertilizer and its smell is awfully strong. It comes from mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them out the door. The word it traveled quickly till it reached the CEO. The VP told him gladly, this is stuff that makes things grow. It's packaged in ceramic and it's very strong indeed. I think that you'll agree that it's exactly what we need. It's made with mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, just keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them out the door. The CEO went to the board and said to them, you know, this substance has the power to make our business grow. They had the news that evening on the business TV shows. The company is growing and it's smelling like a rose. They're growing mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, you keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them out the door. The engineer, he heard the news and muttered, it's a crime how other guys get all the nifty projects all the time. We have a real disaster here that just won't go away, 'cause no one ever listens to a single word we say. Because we're mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, you keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them off the door. We all are mushrooms, mushrooms, I heard the boss remark. Mushrooms, mushrooms, you keep them in the dark. You feed them bits of bullshit till they can't take any more. When they stick their heads up, cut them off and ship them out the door.
Engineer, that's what I do all day.
My name is Nick. I like to add a line. I'm the worst engineer you'll ever find.
Not worst, ho, baddest.
Oh, I'm the baddest engineer you'll ever find.
They call me Joe, the software man. I massage code like no one can.
And I'm Rick, my friends. I program too. At $100 a line, I'll write one for you.
We all calculate and do design. Test that box and deliver it on time.
That graph.
Plot that graph.
Out of bed.
And out of food.
Out the door.
I'm one bad dude.
We get to work and into our stalls. Make some coffee, make a few calls.
Pick up my assignment from the pile.
Then place it in the circular file.
Ah, donuts today. What's the deal?
It's a customer review
and our free meal.
First management decisions must be made. That can only be done by the highest paid.
I'm technical leader. Our path is set. You get the plane. I'll eat the chocolate.
We say, good.
They say, good.
We say, oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I sit right down and go through my mail.
Try to make my way down the paper trail.
Then on to a meeting in a conference room.
Catch those weeks and wake up at noon.
We all calculate and do design. Test that box and deliver it on time.
Back to lunch, I need a rest.
But we're just in time for acceptance test.
Sweep the knob.
Turn the dial.
Hit return.
And wait for a while. And wait for a while.
Hey, what's going on here?
How are you?
And wait for
a while. Does it always take this long?
It's usually much faster than this.
It's not my fault. I knew it wouldn't work.
It's not my fault. It must have been a quirk.
Don't look at me. I think it went berserk.
Kick it.
What?
Kick it.
Now do it again at
hot and cold.
Shake your thing and paint it gold.
I present to you for all to see
the XYZ serial number 3.
It meets the specs.
It's under cost.
Please take the sting and then
get lost.
I'd like to improvise to go with the flow.
But you know the song is under change control. We all calculate and do design. Break that box and blame it on the other guy.
It's not my fault.
It's not my fault.
You broke it, you bithead.
Who you call a bithead?
It's a hardware bug.
It's a software bug.
It's two bugs in one.
Box for you
and deliver
it on time.
We all calculate and do design. Test that box for you
and deliver it on time.
We all calculate.
We should
did math in high school, thought typing was for the birds. But when the Silicon Valley exploded, it was the shot heard round the world of my new disk drive. And a whole new attitude. And now the only time I'm sad's when I get them killer Viet blues. I was a-cruising on the bulletin boards one fine afternoon. I met a hot little gal, said, will you boot up with me soon? And she flashed her cursor, I flashed mine. And the rest, they say, is data. We had a grand old time. And I put it to a straight, I said, I'll format your disk, I'll input your files, I'll plug in my modem and auto-dial you in style. Cause when I'm online with you, baby, there's no way we can lose. But when there's no one at the keyboard, I get them killer Viet blues. It's worse, my peripherals won't configure, there's a surge in my line. My daisy wheels got weeds, but hey, I don't mind. Cause when I'm online with you, baby, there's no way we can lose. But when there's no one at the keyboard, I get them killer Viet blues. I'll input it right now. My terminal's terminal, my spreadsheet's not fitted, IBM can go to hell. Tell me, mama, who will your database manager be? You know I don't mind consulting when I'm at my VDT. Video display terminal, come on, get with it now. And I'll format your disk, I'll input your files, I'll plug in my modem and auto-dial you in style. Cause when I'm online with you, baby, there's no way we can lose. But when there's no one at the keyboard, 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 I get them killer Viet blues.
Buy computers. They said $1 million for a brand new mainframe IBM. Now that price really sucks. So I looked at all the pictures and I chose to build my own. For you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Oh, IBM DEC and Honeywell, HPDT and Wang. And ALNEC and NCR, they don't know anything. They make big bucks for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Well, take the CPU, you see it's only just a box with blinking lights and whirring fans and lots of cable slots. Well, I spent an evening working with some wire and bolts and pins. Then I hauled them to the basement and I plugged the freezer in. Oh, IBM DEC and Honeywell, HPDT and Wang. And ALNEC and NCR, they don't know anything. They make big bucks for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Well, next I needed tape drives. My tape drives were a steal. I climbed into the attic for my dad's old reel-to-reel. Some cable and some binder twine, and soon it was complete. My CPU and tape drive at a price no one can beat. Oh, IBM DEC and Honeywell, HPDT and Wang. And ALNEC and NCR, they don't know anything. They make big bucks for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Well, then I looked for disk drives, but it didn't take me long. Function follows form, they say, or have I got that wrong? Well, I found a drive with 5 new modes that blow the rest away. Cottons, linens, wash and wear, rinse and lingerie. Oh, I need that just to see the CDG. And ALNEC and NCR, they don't know anything. They make
big box for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Well, I had to have a console just to make my system run. Without a fancy console, then my system wasn't done. So I tied a 10-buck typer to a broken TV tube. And now I've got a console that can write the evening news. So I named Deck and Honeywell, HP, DG, and Wang. Amdolek and NCR, they don't know anything. They make big bucks for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Well, I've had my system running. I'll admit it's not the best. The data isn't right, and the response time is a mess. It crashes every hour, and it isn't worth a damn. But I'm satisfied because it runs just like an IBM. All right, now let's everybody get in on this one, okay? A 1, a 2, a 12, 13, 17, 18, IBM Deck and Honeywell, HP, DG, and Wang. I'm Donek and NCR, they don't know anything. They make big bucks for systems, so they never want it known that you can build a mainframe from the things you find at home. Yes, you can build a mainframe from the things.